Alright, so this is a suggestion via Patreon. The name of the song is Trapped in the Drive-Thru, by the artist Weird Al Yankovic. Listen, if you are new here, please like and subscribe the more that you like this content. The more that I know that you specifically would like to see more of this specific type of content, okay? Let's go and just jump into this immediately. The name of the song is Trapped in the Drive-Thru. Apparently, it is a parody of R. Kelly's Trapped in a Closet, which I recall somewhat vividly, I would say. It's been probably a decade, right? But let's jump into it, guys. Lyrics are to the left, my left, right? Just in case we need them in long form. All right, let's go. Oh, this is 11 minutes. All right.
O'clock in the evening, watching something stupid on TV. I'm zoned out on the sofa when my wife comes in the room and sees me. And she says, is this behind the music with Leonard Skinner?
So he's watching something stupid on TV, and then she comes in and she sees it and says, oh, is this behind the music with Leonard Skinner? Okay. So I think maybe she thinks that they're stupid, potentially. I don't know. Listen, so I've encountered Leonard Skinner once. Great band. Not a single complaint there, guys. Right? But all right, let's continue. Let's see where this goes.
And she says, is this behind the music with Leonard Skinner? And I say, I don't know. Say, it's getting late. What you want to do for dinner? She says, I kind of had a big lunch, so I'm not super hungry. I said, well, you know, baby, I'm not starving either, but I could eat. She says, well,
this is such a real conversation.
What do you have in
like, I don't know if you guys are married or whatever, bro, but this is such a real conversation.
I said, I don't know, what about you? She says, I don't care if you're hungry, let's eat. I said, that's what we're going to do. But first, you got to tell me what it is you're hungry for. And she says, let me think, what's left in our refrigerator? I said, well, there's tuna, I know. She said, that went bad a week ago. I said, is the chili okay? She said, you finished that yesterday. I hopped up and said, I don't know, do you want to get something delivered? And she's like, why would I want to eat liver? I don't even like liver.
What?
I'm like,
delivered. Liver. Oh, man.
I hopped up and said, I don't know, do you want to get something delivered? She's like, why would I want to eat liver? I don't even like liver. I'm like, no, I said deliver.
Guys, don't get married. Stay single. This is basically the overall conversation, I would say. It kind of goes like this, guys. It does.
She's like, I heard you say liver. I'm like, I should know what I said. She's like, whatever, I just don't want any liver.
Bro, just this is how you do it. This is how you do it. Give you some advice. Just let her win. That's it. You know you're right. Just let her win. Whatever.
I'm like, I should know. You're
right.
What I said.
She's
like, whatever.
I said.
Just don't want any liver.
No liver. Don't worry.
I was gonna say something, but my cell phone started to ring. Now who could be calling me? Well, I checked my caller ID. It was just cousin Larry calling for the third time today. My wife said, let it go to voicemail.
This man's phone says Brokio. Instead of Nokia. Is it Nokia? What's Nokia, right? Or Nokia. Brokia, maybe is what it says. Interesting. Let's get it. Yeah, it says Brokia.
Calling for the third time today. My wife said, let it go to voicemail. I said, okay. Where were we? Oh, dinner, right. So what do you want to do? She says, why don't you whip up something in the kitchen? Yeah, I said, why don't you? And then she says, baby, can't we just go out to dinner, please? I says, no. She says, yes. I says, no. She says, yes. I says, no. She says, yes. Oh, here's your keys. I step a little bit closer. Say, okay, where you wanna go? She says, how about the Ivy? I said, yeah, well, I don't know. I don't feel like getting all dressed up and eating expensive food. She says, Olive Garden. I say, nah, I'm not in the mood. And Burrito King would make me gassy, there's no doubt.
Right.
She says, just forget about it. I said, no, I swear I'm gonna take you out. Then I get an idea.
Okay.
I say, I know what we'll do. She says, what? I say, yes. She says, what? I say, we're going to the drive-thru.
So we head out the front door, open the garage door, then I open the car doors, and we get in those car doors.
Guys, if you got, hopefully, listen, I really hope you guys have seen the original, like, video, because, like, it was, well, it wasn't as ridiculous as this. This is definitely more ridiculous, right? But, like, the overall pacing of the song is almost identical, guys. And this, I find it hilarious. Let's continue, guys.
My key in the ignition, and then I turn it sideways. Then we fasten our
ignition,
seatbelts,
one of R. Kelly's songs.
Then we drive to the drive-through, heading off to the drive-through.
Hold on, guys. We have to make sure we read everything, obviously. Okay. Fletcher and family. Okay.
Getting close to the drive-through. Almost there at the drive-through.
Just so we don't miss any references.
Here in line at the drive-through. Did I mention the drive-through?
Yeah, you did, bro. You mentioned the drive-through. We're here. We're here. Then it's gonna be act two.
Here we are in the drive-thru line. Me and her. Cars in front of us, cars in back of us, all just waiting to order. There's some idiot in a Volvo with his bright sun behind me. I lean out the window and
this is so real, bro.
Scream, hey, what you trying to do, blind me?
Yes.
Says maybe we should park. We could just go eat inside. I said
oh, no.
I'm wearing bunny slippers. So
bro, exactly. Listen, so I left my house the other day, and I was like, all right, I'm going to go ahead and get some, let's go grab something to eat, right? And I had, like, a shirt on that was obviously too small, apparently, because I had it underneath my hoodie, right? It was just getting a little cold, right? Yeah, and then, you know, then it got a little hot. I took my hoodie off, and then all of a sudden, let's go get something to eat and sit down in inside of a building. I'm not going in there with my schmedium shirt on, bro. We're not doing that. Alright, so right now you and I are here, sir.
We could just go eat inside. I said I'm wearing bunny slippers, so I ain't leaving this ride. Now a woman on a speaker box is saying, can I take your order, please? I said, yes, indeed, you certainly can. We'd like two hamburgers with onions and cheese. Then my wife says, baby, hold on, I've changed my mind.
Oh.
I think I'm gonna have a chicken sandwich instead this time. I said, you always get a cheeseburger. She says, that's not what I'm hungry for. I put my head in my hands and scream. I don't
rage.
Know who you are anymore. The voice on the speaker says, I don't have all day. I said, then take her order and we'll be on our way. I wanna get a chicken sandwich, and I want a cheeseburger too. She's like, you want onions on that? I'm like, yeah, I already said that I do.
Exactly.
Plus we need curly fries, and don't you dare forget it. And two medium root beers, no, just one, we'll split it. Then I said, I'm guessing that you're probably not too bright.
Ooh.
So read me back my order, let's make sure you got it right. She says, one, you want a chicken sandwich? Two, you want a cheeseburger? Three, curly fries and a large root beer? Stop, don't go no further. I never ordered a large root beer, I said medium. Then she says, we're having a specialized supersized you at no charge. Oh.
Oh.
And that's all I could say was, oh. And she says, now there's something else that I really think you should know.
Okay.
You can have unlimited refills for just a quarter more. I say,
oh.
Great, except we're in the drive-thru.
That's how they get you, the upcharge. But how are we going to get that in the drive-thru? That's a really good question.
So what would I want that for? Then she says, wait a minute. Your voice sounds so familiar. Hey, is this Paul?
Oh.
And my wife is all like, no, that ain't Paul. Now tell me who's this.
Oh,
Paul.
Shit.
She says, oh, he's just some guy who goes to school with me. I sat behind him last year and I copied off of him in geometry. I said, I know a guy named Paul. He used to be my plumber. He was prematurely bald. Then he moved to Pittsburgh last summer.
What does this have to do with the same guy? How is this the same guy,
really
bro?
Bad
oh.
And she says, mister, please, you can stop right there. That's way more than I needed to know. And then we both were quiet, and things got real intense. And then she says, next window, please, that'll be $5.82. So we inched ahead in line, moving painfully slow. I got a little bored, so I turned on the radio.
All right, let's go. Oh. This is weird. This specific part. Because if it looks like they're being blown from the front, right? I get that it's an animation. It's supposed to be like a cartoon and like the weird things like this happen. But normally car speakers are not, like specifically loudspeakers, they're not like in that position to even do that. If that was supposed to be plausible, the speakers were on the door, so their legs would be doing that, but not really their head. I don't know. I think about things like this, guys. All right, let's continue. I need an explanation.
Click, turned it off because my wife was getting a headache.
Oh.
So we both just sat there quietly.
They just touched their hair and fixed it.
For her sake. Well, then I looked at her, and she looked back at me.
All right.
And I said, I think you have something in your teeth.
Of course.
She turned away from me and then turned back and said, did I get it?
No, you didn't get it.
I said, yeah. Well, I mean, most of it. But hey, you know, don't sweat it.
Most of it.
Then she said, how about now? I said, yeah, almost.
Of course.
There's still a little bit there, but don't worry. It's probably just a piece of toast. Now we're at the pay window.
Looks like spinach.
Window, or whatever you call it. Put my hand in my pocket. I can't believe there's no wallet. Wallet.
Oh, what a waste of your time, sir.
And the lady at the window's like, well, 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 that'll be $582. I turn around to my wife and say, how much have you got on you? She just rolls her eyes and says, I'll pay for this, I guess. So she reaches into her purse and busts out the American Express. I hand it to the lady, and she says, oh dear.
She's so angry, right? The wife. Listen, if you're married, don't you split the money or split your income? Or like all the money, is there's no more I? It's like I guess I'll pay for it. No, we will pay for it. The money is ours. No, I don't know. Maybe I'm weird. All right, let's continue.
I hand it to the lady, and she says, oh dear, it's gotta be cash only.
No.
We don't take credit cards here.
Shouldn't that have been written like on the area where they like were talking to the lady originally, potentially? I mean, then the time wouldn't have been wasted.
I took back the card and said, gee, really? Well, that sucks. And that's when I found out my wife was only carrying $3. I said, I thought you were gonna hit the ATM today. She says, I never got around to it, so where's your wallet anyway? And I said, never mind, just help me to find some change. Now the lady at the window's looking at me kind of strange. And
yeah, because now you're taking up the time, guys, right? Don't they have like a timer or something on the inside of the drive-thru, guys? Yeah, you're wasting time.
She says, mister, please, we gotta move this line along. I said, now hold your stinking horses, lady, we won't be long. So I looked around inside the glove box and checked the mat beneath my feet. I found a nickel in an ashtray and
okay,
a couple
good.
Pennies and a
We're
dime in the space between the seats.
We're getting there.
Before long, I had a little pile of coins of every sort.
The lady
counts it up and says, you're still about a dollar short. And now my woman's got this weird look frozen on her face. She screams, you know, I wasn't even really hungry in the first place.
Yes, you
and
were.
So I turned around to the cashier again. I shrugged and said, okay, forget the chicken sandwich then. So I pick up my change, pick up my receipt.
Bro, she's gonna eat your whole sandwich.
And I drive to the pickup window. Man, I just can't
never
wait
do that.
To eat.
Never do that,
now
bro.
We see this acne-ridden kid about 16.
All right.
Wearing a dorky name tag that says, hello, my name is Eugene. He hands me a paper bag. I look him in the eyes and I say to him, hey Eugene, could I get some ketchup for my fries?
Charge him.
Well, he looks at me and I look at him and he looks at me and I look at him and he looks at me and I look at him and he says, I'm sorry. What did you want again?
What the hell was he doing? He hands her, he's not even there, bro. Right? Eugene, he's not there, bro. He hands you the food. He doesn't expect for you to talk to him, right?
Say ketchup, and he says, oh yeah, that's right. Just finished out there for a a second. I'm really kind of burnt tonight.
Oh.
And then he hands me the ketchup. And now we're finally driving away. And the food is driving me mad with its intoxicating bouquet. I'm starving to death by the time we pull up at the traffic light. I say, baby, give me that burger. I just gotta have a bite.
Yes, of course they forgot the onions, bro. Listen, I have gone through so many drive-thrus in my life, obviously, right? And there's something wrong, I would say, guys. 55% of the time, there's something wrong. So of course they forgot the onions, bro.
They forgot the onions.
Yeah, end of the, messed up your night. You did all of that. This is so real, bro. Huh? This is perfect. Oh, we're done? Oh, yeah, we're done. All right. Guys. What is this? No, stop playing. Hold on, guys. Hold on, guys. Hold on, guys. Yeah, yeah. Listen, not a single complaint. This is probably the most real thing I've heard in my life. Right? Trapped in a drive-thru. Perfection. Not a single complaint here. My favorite parts were... The entire, like, as soon as it got to the actual drive-thru itself, that was when I think it picked up amazingly for me, right? Because initially it was like, okay, yeah, it's absolutely real. But then as soon as he gets to the drive-thru, it's just like, oh, this is my life exactly. All right? Listen, so let me know in the comments on the next thing from him I should be listening to. And I'll get into that as soon as I possibly can. All right? And listen, you guys all have an amazing day and enjoy it thoroughly.